Friends, let's rapid revise the graph theory in detail. In the previous lecture, we studied about some of the useful results in the related to graph theory. Now we are heading towards the very important topic, special graphs. Okay, that is very important. If you want to solve a question in graph theory, you need to understand the vocabulary and the definitions. Okay, you need to understand the basic what type of graph is what, and then only you can able to solve the question. Okay, so basically overview given that special graphs, I will be discussing about 8 types of graphs. So you need to have command over each and every graph, and we will be doing that. We'll be finding number of vertices, edges and degree of vertices in a generalized manner. Okay, so first of all, you will be heading towards the null graph. Okay, the first graph is our null graph. So as the name suggests that it is represented by NN, as the name suggests, it is a null graph. That means it is a graph with no edges. Okay, so you can say graph with no edges. That means it will be having N, for NN, N vertices will be there, but still no edges is there. Okay, like this you can say. So we can make a table regarding it. Okay, so for NN, the vertices are N, edges 0, and degree of vertices is nothing but the number of edges incident on the vertex, so that's why it is also 0. Okay, so also you can say that the degree of vertices whenever 0, it is also known as isolated vertex. Okay, so keep that terms in mind, so in order to solve the questions. Now heading towards the next type of graph, that is cycle graph. Okay, so cycle graph is represented by CN. Okay, so let's head on. Okay, suppose cycle is not possible for n is equals to 1 or 2. Okay, obviously it is very obvious. Suppose vertex is 1, cycle is not possible. 2 also, cycle is not possible. And for 3, cycle is possible. So we will be considering, okay, we will be considering for CN, which is n is greater than equal to 3. So that you should keep in mind. Sometimes MCQ you may get wrong because of this. Okay, so you have to keep in mind that n is greater than equal to 3. What is a cycle graph actually? A cycle graph is a simple graph with n vertices. Okay, v1, v2 up to vn, in which vi is adjacent to vi plus 1. Suppose vi is adjacent to vi plus 1, and what happens is vn is adjacent to vi, v1. Okay, so let's take it with an example. Suppose this is n equals 3, cn, c3. So what is there? It is a 3 cycle graph. Okay, so 3 cycle graph is there, and here you can say that here v1, v2, v3. So what is the definition saying? That every vi is adjacent to vi plus 1, that is v1 is adjacent to v2, v2 is adjacent to v3, and it is also saying that vn, nth means last one, is adjacent to the first one. So this is also satisfying this, that's why it is a cycle graph. Similarly, for 4 cycle graph, C4 denoted by C4, C4 consists of 4 vertices, and such that V1 adjacent to V2, V2 adjacent to V3, V3 adjacent to V4, and V4 is adjacent to starting one, that is V1. So, generalizing it, okay, so we can generalize it for, you have to keep in mind n is greater than equal to 3, otherwise it will not work. So, okay, CN is there, vertices, edges and degree of vertices. So vertex is what? Suppose CN is there, so vertex will be N only. And for E you have to keep in mind that let's observe it from these graphs, that here three vertex are there and three edges are also there. Four vertex are there and four edges are also there. Similarly, if you take C5 also, you can see that five vertices, five edges are present. So for every corresponding vertex, one edge is present. So you say that n is number of edges is also n. So degree of vertex, we can say that for every vertex, you can say that only two edges are incident, so you can find that degree of vertex is 2. Okay friends, so this is all for cycle graph. Now heading towards the third type of graph, that is wheel graph. Okay, so wheel graph is there. So wheel graph is also represented by Wn, and here also n must be greater than equal to 3. You can say. Now what is there? Okay, wheel graph is there. So W3, if we can say. So you have to keep in mind, sometimes it is given that number of vertices in a wheel graph is 3. Suppose this is said. So you have to not confuse it. Okay, I will explain it afterwards. So W3 is what this is. This is C3. C3 plus one vertex. Okay, that is known as hub, which is connected to each and every vertex, is known as wheel graph. Okay, nothing like that. Okay, so it is basically Cn plus one additional vertex. Okay, so it might be sometimes confusing to it. Okay, so Wn actually containing not n vertices. Wn will contain n plus one vertices. That is a point to be noted. Otherwise, you may commit mistake while doing the question. Okay, some questions are really twisting because of that only. Suppose we are taking W4, okay, four vertices and this much edges. Oh, sorry. Yeah, this is a central hub. Let's make it once. Yeah. So if we make W4, so this is C4, okay, C4 plus one additional vertex in between. So we're getting like this. So this is one hub plus C4. C4 plus 1, that is W4. Okay, so number of vertex is 5 and number of edges is, we'll count it, okay? We'll make a observation, nice observation. For suppose C is, W5 is C5 plus 1, okay? W5 is C5 plus 1, you can say. So if we count the number of vertex here, so vertex will be suppose C and M. Plus additional vertex 1, so n plus 1 vertices is there. So here 3 is there, 3 plus 1, that is 4 vertex for W3. For W4, 5 vertex. For W5, 6 vertex, like this. For number of edges, you can say it will take edges as C3. How many edges are there? Plus it is connected, this hub is connected to each and every vertex, so number of vertex n. So C3, you can observe that C3 will contain n edges. So n plus n is 2n. So Cn will contain 2n edges. That is the point. You can see from here that, Cn, Wn. Okay, like this. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, for W8, number of edges is 8. For W4, edges is 8. For 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, W5, the number of edges are 10. So similarly, you can see that number of edges will be 2n. So let's generalize it and make it in a table in a systemized manner, okay? Like this, you can see. This is Wn. This is the point to be noted. For Wn, vertex will be n plus 1. For edges, you can say, we have derived it, 2n. Okay, for degree of vertex, you can say, it is different for hub and non-hub vertices. Okay, for hub you can say that hub is connected to each and every vertex, so for hub it must be n. Okay, for hub it must be n for hub. Okay, for 3, matlab this one it is 3, 1 2 3. For this hub it is 4 2 3 4. For this hub it is 5, so like that you can say. Okay, n for hub. And if it is not hub, other than this, what will happen? It's merely a cycle graph. Cycle graph is having 2 as the degree of each vertex, but here 1 is also for the connecting hub. So that will be 3. 3 if it is not hub. Okay. So this is how you can see the wheel graph. Okay. Now for the next graph, you can say. Okay, next graph we are seeing Next graph is complete graph. Okay, complete graph. Complete graph means KN, represented by KN. Okay, and what do you mean by complete graph? Complete graph is nothing which is having the maximum number of edges, you can say. Yeah, or you can say it is a simple graph with n vertices in such a way that every pair of vertices are adjacent. Suppose this is a graph. Okay, here what is there? Each and every pair is adjacent. Each and every vertex pair is adjacent to each other. This is one observation. Second one is that maximum number of edges is there. So what is the maximum number of edges? We already discussed in the previous results. That is n minus 1 by 2. Let's check out for this. That is 4 into 3 by 2. That is equals to 6. Let's check it is 6 or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 edges. So maximum possible edges we have covered. So this is known as complete graph. Okay. And it is represented by Kn. Kn is for Kuratowski theorem. Kuratowski is a great scientist, mathematician. Okay. It was named after him only. Complete graph. Now let's make a table for it also. So it's very simple. We already discussed because of the useful results, it is very simple. Now Kn for number of vertices, edges and degree of vertices. For vertices, for Kn, n will represent the number of vertex. And for E, E is what? Number of edges. You know that number of edges as n into n minus 1 by 2, that is maximum number of edges in a complete graph. Now, for calculating the degree of vertex, we know that the sum of the degree of vertices is equals to the twice the number of edges. Okay, so you can do it like that also. Okay, like that. N matlab kitne vertices and degree of vertex you have to find out. So it is can be x, and twice the number of edges n into n minus 1 by 2. So you can derive it like this also, x equals n minus 1. So degree of vertex will be n minus 1 since each vertex is having same degree. Okay, or you can derive it through observation. For suppose complete one, this k1 will be trivial graph. K1 is known as trivial graph. K2 is known as maximum one edge can be there. Nothing known as, okay, one edge is there. The degree of vertex will be n minus 1, that is 1. For K3, maximum is this connectivity. Degree is 2. So you can see that, you can prove it through observation also now. we have covered 4 of the special graphs. Now in the next lecture, we will be covering the next 4 special graphs, which are very important in order to solve a question. So that's all for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. So please like, comment and subscribe. Bye for now. Thank you.